it's my pleasure to introduce our last but not least speaker, Dasha Redka. Dasha is an applied scientist at Cyclica, and she will speak about drug repurposing, specifically PolypharmDB. Dasha, welcome, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much for having me. Can you see my deck?
Yes, we can.
Okay, great. Thank you so much. So yeah, my name is Dasha. I'm an applied scientist at Cyclica. We are an AI-based drug discovery company based in Toronto, Canada. And today I want to tell you about our drug repurposing tool called PolypharmDB, and specifically about how we applied it for COVID-19. You have seen this slide in Andre's presentation, and probably you look at this every day. While the vaccination against SARS-CoV-2 is underway, our cases are still very high, and there is still a need for a broad spectrum therapeutical intervention in order to mitigate this current and possible future pandemics of coronaviruses. Just to give you a little bit of a preview of the punchline of this talk so that you know where I'm headed, I will be telling you about the process we went through to uncover an antiviral activity of an approved oral drug, the entire story with the drug identity, and more specifics on the technology will be published tomorrow. But today I want to tell you about this amazing multi-party Canadian private and public partnership between Ryerson University, University of Toronto, Vector Institute, and Cyclica being at the epicenter, both mediating this collaboration and contributing its technology and funding to the project. Before I go on, I also want to give a big thanks to the Canadian Institute for Advanced Research and National Research Council for supporting this project as well. The viral cycle is quite a complex process, which gives scientists a lot of opportunities to interfere with this process and come up with antiviral medications. There are antivirals on the market that are targeting the viral proteins involved in this cycle, but there are also some that are targeting the host proteins as well. When faced with a new virus like SARS-CoV-2, the challenge is to identify that essential protein or part of this process to interfere with in order to fight that infection. But let's say that we have found that target, that protein that is essential for the virus to stop replicating. Even further, let's imagine that we used whatever tool that we have in our disposal to quickly find the ligand and novel activator or inhibitor for that protein or target that we've identified. And in a couple of slides, I'll tell you what we are proposing as one of our tools for doing that. But what is next once we've done that? Today, in this pandemic, when the world is in lockdown, will finding that novel molecule help us? Because it takes about 10 years, as it was discussed here today, to get a drug approved for being used on the market. And there is also a high failure rate associated with that process. So what can we do to speed this up? Are all efforts for drug discovery pointless at this point? What can AI specifically do in this process? And what can Cyclica as an AI drug discovery company do in this case? These are some of the questions that we have been struggling with on our team ever since we initiated our COVID-19 work a year ago. And so one thing we thought we could utilize in this case is this concept of polypharmacology, which is actually the fundamental principle on which Cyclica was built. And that is that a given molecule is estimated to interact with something on the order of dozens of proteins in our bodies. But typically, we do not know about all of these off-target interactions, some of which are beneficial, and some of these could be actually detrimental or toxic. So what we thought we could do, if we took all the drugs out there for which there is clinical data, of which there is about 10,000, where at least we know something about the toxicity and bioavailability of those molecules, and find out about every protein that those molecules bind to. Can we, in doing so, exploit every possible therapeutic potential of these drugs that have clinical data? And Now then the question would be, how would we exploit or explore that therapeutic potential of those molecules? Well, to do that, we can use one of our two main machine learning engines that we have built at Cyclica. And we call this engine MatchMaker. This engine predicts whether a given molecule would interact with a given protein. It is a deep learning model built on millions of drug target interactions, as well as thousands of 3D structures. It is very runtime efficient, and that's what allows us to have a high throughput screening. And that's why we can exhaustively screen millions of molecules against thousands of human proteins in a reasonable amount of time. So using MatchMaker, we took these 10,000 drugs, of which about 2,000 are approved. We featureized them using MatchMaker, and we evaluated their binding to each of the proteins that we have in our MatchMaker model, of which there is about 8,500 human proteins. In the end, what we end up with are 10,000 by about 8,000 predictions for the likelihood of binding of each drug to each protein in our model, and we call this resource PolypharmDB. And now that we have that, all we need is are some relevant targets for our problem. And then we can pull out molecules previously not reported to interact with those targets we would identify in the first step out of the PolypharmDB. And in doing so, therefore, we would be recycling drugs. This is what the sign is supposed to represent. Of course, we need some experimental validation because these are merely computational predictions. So when we started our COVID-19 work a year ago, we published this preprint in ChemArchives where we used PolypharmDB to propose repurposing opportunities. But of course, the big problem there was that we did not have the cycle fully closed. We were missing two major links here. One was that the targets that we have identified were taken from a literature review based on previous coronaviruses experimental projects. And two, we did not have a chance to test these predictions experimentally. So now, almost exactly a year from the time that we published that preprint, another preprint is going to be published tomorrow, where we set up this fruitful collaboration where we used targets predicted by an AI algorithm from the Vector Institute to mine our Cyclica PolypharmDB tool. And then in a collaboration with Ryerson Institute, we had those predictions tested experimentally in a cell-based assay and biochemical assays. And it turns out that it is good to collaborate. it's really good to close the cycle. As I mentioned, we will be sharing this work tomorrow. And although we are excited to share these results, it is also quite exciting to find this application of previously approved drugs in this using this research PolyPharm DB. And we are even more excited about what are the implications of this platform for drug repurposing. So if you're interested in learning more about PolypharmDB and some of the other collaborations we have in that respect, please reach out to us and we can have a conversation. Thank you very much.
Dasha, thank you very much for this very interesting, excellent presentation.